Someone needs help understanding the monumental value of believing in yourself. Welcome to Unifier TV, where truth has no fear. I want to motivate everyone who is watching and listening to this to believe in you. In order to be able to feel like you can buy a product and continue buying a product, you have to believe in it. You have to trust that it works. You have to trust its value. Even if you spend a little more money than you're willing to spend, if the value is up to par, if it performs to the level that you expect it to, or maybe even exceeds that, you're willing to spend that extra money. If you choose to donate to someone in their platform and you want to do that, you have to believe in that person. You have to buy into that person in order to be willing to give your hard-earned dollars to someone who can do a whole lot of things with it and build their platform up. You have to believe in them, and that takes work. So that person may not even believe in themselves, but it motivates them to believe in themselves when you help them out. So I challenge you today to find someone to uplift. It could be someone in your family. It could be in the workplace. It could be someone on social media who you know is struggling right now emotionally. They're going through a tough time in their family. They just need someone to tell them good things. It doesn't have to be financial. It could be just the right words that God gives you to give them that could just ignite that thing within them that says, you know what? I got this. I can make it past this. This is not permanent. This is strictly temporary, and I'm strong enough to handle this. Sometimes people just need words. Sometimes there's no material thing, there's no monetary thing that could suffice to the point where it just really makes someone get up and say, I'm good. So you can't put a price on that. Sometimes you can, but you know, let God lead the way. My point is, there's someone out there that needs to be motivated. It could be you. It could be you. If you need to be motivated, find someone that has those words. Sometimes people always know just what to say. Most people know that one person that always knows what to say. If you don't have that person, even if you do have that person, I strongly urge you to seek Christ, because he is the best friend you could possibly have. And, you know, it, like I said, whether you have that person or not, God does put people in our lives to do those things for us, to motivate us, to get us back on our feet, to pick us up when we fall, you know, literally and figuratively. You know, but God does that for us. Whether, you know, he's sending someone our way, you know, or he is giving us that spiritual inclination, that motivation directly from him. So I encourage you guys to find someone to motivate. And if you yourself need to be motivated, find positive podcasts, find positive videos. Just overload yourself with that positivity, because the devil is busy. There are so many distractions in this world. There's so many things that we can easily look at and say things are going to hell. Things are terrible. I don't want to have kids and raise them in a world like this. I myself am ready to go because I want to go and go to heaven because this world is too much to handle. Okay, it's great to want to go to heaven, but at the same time, we are here for a purpose and we have work to do. You know, you can only watch your clock, but for so many times and so long at work before you become completely unproductive. You can't sit there watching the clock. Chances are you're not getting any work done. Let's work until it's time to go home. It helps the time pass a whole lot better. Trust me, you'll be a lot more proud of yourself if you work through your shift rather than sitting there looking at the time go by. So while we are here, let's put in that work. Let's motivate others. Let's uplift each other. Some people talk a lot about the echo chamber. And yeah, that does exist in a lot of realms, but at the same time, sometimes that echo chamber will echo to a certain part of that tunnel that hasn't been affected yet. The echo helps. It starts at this point, then it trickles down. Go, go, go. And next thing you know, people are catching that sound that didn't really catch it the same way before, not at all. The echo chamber is not always a bad thing, because it's going to reach someone who hasn't heard that first echo come out ever. So let's continue to keep our foot on the gas, especially in times like this. Let's erase the color lines. Let's erase the political lines. Let's erase those things that divide us, no matter what it is, no matter if it's gender equality, racial equality, the politics, the, you know, all this stuff that gets people fighting every day. Let's get past that, because at the end of the day, we are all citizens. We are all patriots. No matter what side of the spectrum you're on, if this is your country, this is your country. And no matter how you voted, no matter what you believe in and don't believe in, if you're a legal citizen of this country, this is your country to fight for and to preserve. And we cannot do this alone. Some good heroes out there who can do a lot more damage than others, but at the end of the day, it takes all of us. So let's motivate each other. Let's pump each other up. Let's get full of the Spirit. Let's get full of God. Find those Bible verses that uplift you and pass them to someone else and see what it does for them. We got to stick in this and we got to stay positive because negativity is waiting around every corner.